Hi everyone, in this video, I will show you different setups to have MongoDB running as a Docker container, and the tools to access the database and collections from your dev environment. MongoDB is a powerful and flexible NoSQL database. It handles vast amounts of data with high scalability. On its turn, Docker is a container solution that every developer must have at least a basic notion how to use it. So join me and let's see how we can put this all together. Before we continue, if you haven't Docker installed in your computer, you can use Docker Desktop for Windows and Mac. The installation is fast and straightforward. With Docker Desktop, you can manage your images and containers using a UI or CLI commands. For Linux, the installation steps can depend a bit on the distribution, but it's also fairly simple. One way to have MongoDB running as a container is directly using Docker to run a container image. A Docker container is an executable unit of software that contains everything needed to run the application. This includes the code, its dependencies, and configurations. A container image is a static file with executable code used to create a container. Let's first check if you have any Mongo images in our computer using the Docker command image with the option filter. If there is no image available locally, we can use the command docker pull to get one from the public registry hub.docker.com. We are using the latest tag here, but we could use a specific version. In the Docker Hub, you can check the images and the recent tags. I will leave the link in the description. Let's check the images again. Note that the image name is Mongo. Now, we can use the command docker run to create a container from the image we just pulled. In fact, if we use the docker run without a previous pulled image, it will do it automatically. The option name is the container's name. If not provided, Docker will use a random name. The option P is used to publish a container's port to the host. Here, we are binding the MongoDB default port 27.0.17 to the host's port 27.0.20. So, for an application to connect to this Mongo instance, it must use the port 27.0.20. The option D means detach. This is to run the container in the background. If not provided, this terminal instance will continuously show the logs until the container is stopped. And Mongo is the image name. The Docker command ps shows all running containers. To display the running processes of the container, without logging into it, we can use the Docker container top command. But let's improve the readability using the command docker exec, which runs commands in the container. So we can use the ps command with the options aux to display the container's active processes. We have the MongoD process running and the ps itself. In MongoD process, note the command colon. This is the command used to start the Mongo database. In this case, using the binary MongoD with the option to bind to all IP4 and 6 addresses. We will use this information further in this video. We can also use exec to open a bash terminal in the container. The options IT means interactive and TTY. Know that we are inside our container. Let's now run the Mongo shell, use the admin database, and create the root user. Now, the authentication should be working. Okay, let's create a new database and a user for it. And then add a new document for the collection products. We use find to retrieve all documents from the collection products. It seems everything is working so far, but we have a limitation with this setup. The data we entered will be available only until the container is removed. Usually, this is not desired. To fix that, we need to use the option volume when creating the container. But before that, let me show you how we can use Docker Desktop to manage our containers. In the main area, we have the information about the existing containers, and you see that you have the buttons to stop and remove any container. To open a terminal for the container, click the three dots and choose the respective option. And that's it. Now, let's improve our setup. The backslash symbol is used here to write a command in multiple lines. In Windows, we can use the git bash terminal to run this. Note that we are using the volume option to map a local directory to the container's internal directory. This way, everything we do in the container will be persisted in the provided directory. And the data will be available even if the container is removed. Run it again, and the data will be there. And we are using the environment variables root username and root password to create a user with root permissions with the specified username and password. Let's open a terminal and Mongo shell in this new container. Note that the root authentication has worked from the start. Now we have a common and quick setup for dev environments. Our next setup uses Docker Compose. Compose is a tool for defining and running multi-container Docker applications. The Compose file is a YAML file defining services, networks, and volumes for a Docker application. Our setup has two services, the MongoDB itself and Mongo-Express. Mongo-Express is a web-based MongoDB admin interface. Let's look at the YAML file. The setup is basically the same we have before, but we have logging options. We have defined local as the log driver, the max size of the log file, and the max number of files. The local driver captures output from the container and writes them to an internal storage optimized for performance and disk use. As it uses log rotation, we are optimizing our dev environment. In the Mongo Express services specification, note the environment variable to connect to Mongo. In the connection string, the server is the Mongo service. Now, we can run the command docker compose app to create the containers. The option D, or detach, works the same way it's used by Docker run. Let's try Mongo Express. This admin tool is lightweight and open source. We have features to create database, collections, documents. There are options to export and import data as well. Since we are talking about MongoDB admin tools, let me show you another two, MongoDB Compass and NoSQL Booster. MongoDB Compass It's the official graphic UI for MongoDB, and much more feature-rich than Mongo-Express. NoSQL Booster is paid, but it has a free version. Particularly, is the tool of my personal choice. It's very powerful and, in my opinion, offers a freedom to build queries and editing data that I don't see in MongoDB Compass. My goal here is not to have a deep comparison between these tools, but simply show you some good options. The first setup is to create a local replica set. A replica set, or cluster, is a group of MongoDB servers containing an identical copy of the data. This increases availability because if one of the servers fails, the other two will pick up the load while the crashed one returns. You can use this setup if you want to test high availability and disaster recovery, or developing replication-specific features. For this setup, we are using Docker Compose and a shell script to automate the process. The Compose file is similar to our last one, but we have three Mongo services. The structure is the same for all services. The entry point is an array with the first element being the Mongo binary and then the arguments. The option replica set is used to set the replica set name, in this case, RS0. The shell script is basically to call the replica set command initiate, passing a configuration object. This object contains the replica set name and the services we create with Docker Compose app. After this, we just create the root user and show the result. Now, let's use MongoDB Compass to test the connection. Yes, it's working as expected. Another good option is to use the free tier from MongoDB Atlas. This is the database as service offering by MongoDB. Using this free tier, you can easily share a database with your team to use a shared test dataset, or even have a distinct test database for each team member. And that's it for today. If you find value in this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to leave your comments below. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video.